our business is struggling. I'm throwing everything I got into it. We're gonna go gold mining.
To find a gold claim, the Hoffmans are traveling to America's last frontier. Buried in the Alaskan wilderness is an estimated $250 billion worth of gold. For over 100 years, men have risked their lives here in the hope of getting rich. And Jack knows the stakes are high. Back in the 80s, he mined for 3 seasons and nearly went bankrupt.
I kept mining, you know, when I just the last dog died, you know.
He was digging nuggets out of the ground when the price of gold was just too low. Since then, gold has gone sky high. Jack and Todd have been on a mission to find the right place to start mining. And now Jack thinks they've found a claim that's a prospector's dream.
What do you got here?
I've seen a lot of ground, and this is it.
Holy cow, he got 29 grams in that one test hole.
There's millions of dollars.
Well, if you think we got a shot, I mean, I'll go all in.
I know we got a shot.
The claim the Hoffmans want to lease is 160 acres of forest and rock around an old ghost town in Porcupine Creek, southeastern Alaska. It belongs to an old mining buddy of Jack's named Earl Foster.
I say, yeah, I'm glad you made it good.
Yeah.
All along here, they all yielded gold from the surface down to 20 feet.
Years.
You take 100 ounces of gold.
Since 1898, prospectors have pulled out nearly $100 million of gold from the Porcupine Creek area.
Dude, that's all gold nuggets right there.
Look at those nuggets, Earl.
But for every smiling miner, there are 100 who never make it. Back in the Klondike gold rush in the 1890s, less than 1% of those who set out struck it rich. But no one's ever prospected on Earl's claim with heavy machinery. And the geological samples suggest there's still $15 million worth of gold in the ground there.
I would work this piece of ground first.
Todd is gambling that with the right equipment, he can beat the odds.
No problem.
We're going for it, man. We're going all the way, so we'll see how we do.
Back in Oregon, they're selling everything that's not nailed down.
Another day, another $1,000.
To pay for the machinery to get at the gold. The money's being spent on 2 excavators, an old dump truck, a front loader, a portable generating station, a semi, and thousands of dollars worth of supplies. What they can't afford to buy, they're building. They're making a shaker and a trommel from scratch.
Oh, yeah!
And reconditioning a pump capable of emptying a swimming pool within minutes. What they need is mining equipment specced out for the wilderness. The Hoffmans are assembling an unemployed bunch of buddies to operate this equipment in Alaska. But there's no spare cash for wages.
These guys are paying their own way until we strike gold.
They're not gonna get paid until we dig the gold out of the ground.
That sounds kind of silly, but I'll tell you what, that's the way it is.